I got a new stylus from a record player, and I got my power back. Not necessarily really. If you notice back over on the over here, I got an extension cord going out, and it's plugged in somewhere else with a power strip with a surge protector, because still haven't figured out why I had no power on that whole wall. I replaced all four outlets and switches on the circuit. I switched out the breaker. No clue. But I got the music. So what am I doing here today, gang? What I'm doing here today is, well, I can't believe it. I'm telling you. Anthony Ferraro, do I have to say anything more? Really, that's all I need to say. As you guys know, not too long ago, he sent me an awesome package with some spectacular records and CDs. Matter of fact, there's a few I haven't even listened to yet because I lost power for a while there. And I didn't want to ruin these CDs by playing them on my computer through my little dinky speakers. Especially since one of them was like 5.1 surround. No, I gotta listen to it the right way. I was waiting. So, still got things to listen to. But then he sends me another box, and I say, what are you doing? Why are you sending me another box, Anthony? You just sent me a box. He goes, that one was because I wanted to, but this one's for your birthday. Using my birthday as an excuse to spoil me. Okay, I guess that's about right, because if you gotta find an excuse to spoil me, I don't know, Anthony, why are you every time? So, let's get to the meat and taters of it all. Mrs. Vivi scored it. I have not looked inside. You know it's going to be awesome and killer because Anthony Ferraro has the best taste in music in all the VC. Besides everybody else who I've told has the best taste in music in the VC. So, no. He is the prog master, but man, he's really good at just rock, classic rock, even some 80s stuff. He's got pretty good taste. So, what is in here? It is an empty sleeve! Actually, I can use that for stiffener and some gifts going out. Oh, by the way, finally, just so you guys know, yes, it's a small box, but this is going out to Rod the Happy Hippie. I got Animal, and this is going out to him. No, it's not a full 12-inch record, but the records aren't here are probably the rarest records I have in my collection. They're 45s, but they are phenomenal. They are awesome. They're going to him. Plus, there's a bonus things in there. Watch his video when he gets it. I gave him some bonus fun inside here. Because you know me, I can't do things normally. Anyway, what's in here? As I know from before, when they ship records and CDs, you can put four CDs in about the same spot where you put an LP record, and there's CDs in here. There's a single Lonely Boy on top. Let us see who this is. Sid Barrett. Who is Sid Barrett? Please don't hate me, guys. The name's familiar, but I'm not ringing a ding-dong in here. Good thing something's playing up here so you guys know what it is. I'll probably be obnoxious and be like, editing Steve here.
Okay, you guys can all yell at me and make fun of me. Yes, Sid Barrett, Pink Floyd. I know David Gilmour. I've heard the name. I've somehow two and two together did not pick up on Sid Barrett. But this is his second and final album that he did solo. It was produced by David Gilmour. So anyway, before y'all look at me and smack me around like I'm an idiot, I'm going to mention, and you'll see that
I don't know who this is.
I didn't, but I did. But I didn't. Sorry.
All right, Barrett. And then I got taped together in CDs again. So I don't want to look. I'm going to tear them off one by one. First one is Eloy Floating. E-L-O-Y. Eloy Floating. Looking at that cover and knowing Anthony, I'm assuming, and that there's, you know, like only 7 or 8 songs on here. Probably a prog band. I'm going to have to discover them, find them out. Eloy. With Ocean. Look at that cover. Yes, this has definitely got to be prog of some sort. Ain't no way it's not. Hey, they got a thing.
Yes, Eloy is a prog band. They're German. Kind of a krautrocky kind of proggy kind of deal going on there. The album you saw there, Floating, was from 1975. It was their third album. And the second album, Ocean, was their sixth album, which was released in, 1977. So, yeah, I kind of like what I heard. Thank you, Anthony. You get some good stuff. Yeah, and there's like, 11, 15 minutes. There's four songs on that Ocean album. It's prog.
All right. Now here is a classic record that I don't have on vinyl that many do and should have it. Again, not considered prog, but is a classic of all time. Lou Reed's Transformer. Oh, that's awesome. Thank you so much. Cool beans. You guys know this one, Because hip-hop nerd guy in me is like, yeah, that Walk on the Wild Side, the song that Marky Mark sampled?
Full of bullet holes with none to blame. Ron became another victim of homicide because he chose to walk on the wild side.
Yeah, and also, Walk on the Wild Side, that song that A Tribe Called Quest sampled? It's still Lou Reed, great stuff, classic album. Thank you so much. Oh, all right. Got some killer CDs, man. I get some stuff I know I like. That's a classic. I got some new product to discover. Woohoo! I am so happy my record player is working and my CD player is working. All right, what's last up? Some dude on a guitar. David Gilmour. Yes, I know who David Gilmour is. It's painful. I know. Just pretending. It's a joke. About Face, David Gilmour solo. Awesome.
All right. About Face is from 1984 from David Gilmour. It's his second studio solo album, and it was kind of like, Pink Floyd was kind of in a weird little funk where they didn't really know where they're going, what they're doing, so he brought this album out. It says here that it peaked at number 21 on the UK albums chart. Huh. Loving the On the Air, which is playing here, and Blue Light, singled off of it. So, there we go. Anyway, just a little more accurate information than what that idiot that you're going to listen to, He didn't know what he was talking about, did he? No, because this idiot used Wikipedia.
Nice, nice, nice. I have never heard this before. I don't even know what it is. What's it from? 2000-something, it says it? I have bad eyes, guys. I can't see it, so. David Gilmour. All right, I think that's it. No, there's something else. He included a record, too. Oh, boy, Anthony. What did you get me on vinyl? It is a copy of Screaming Man! Yay! Come on, guys. As a record collector, there's four records that everybody should have in their collection as a vinyl collector. Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon. But I do not have, nor have I ever had, nor have I ever heard anything off of Court of the Crimson King.
And I'm going to keep it that way. I'm not going to look up anything or play any samples off of it because it is a super rock hard solid classic by most, and I haven't heard anything off of it. I'm going to wait till my virgin listen on the virgin spin of that record to be the first time I hear Court of the Crimson King. So, no samples being played on this one. It's a surprise for me.
That is awesome. I can't wait. I know sometimes I'm late to the boat, and I can paddle and get back on the boat eventually. Still go some swimming, but, you guys took off without me. Everybody has. No, I have not heard anything on here. I even had Sack a long time ago start talking to me about, you know, King Crimson. I'm like, I don't got no clue, man. You know? This is, 200 gram super heavyweight vinyl 50th anniversary 2LP set with an album of alternative takes and studio takes, all mixes approved by Robert Fripp. Wow. Look at that, gang. Wow. Now this is a treat.
You pick your nose.
Oh, right. Anthony, you did it again. It's going to be funny. I'm going to be editing this and what's playing over there. First King's Crimson I've heard off of this album. Before I even put the album on, because I have to put something in it. You know what? I'm pointing at nothing. I'm going to play. Yeah, I'm going to edit it. Of course there's something playing right here. Anyway, thank you so much, Anthony. As always, you spoil me. I love these. I appreciate these. They're going to have a great home here. And the most important thing is my education, my learning. Because there's a lot of stuff here that I need to listen to and know and appreciate in a genre of music that I was left behind on. And I'm getting caught up pretty quickly, thanks to Anthony. Thank you, my man. I hope to be a master someday like you. Take care. And as always, it doesn't matter if it's a tiny 4.7-inch disc or a 12-inch disc. All plastic and vinyl lives, acrylic lives matter. Vinyl? Just get out of here. Thanks, guys. Bye.